Hello everyone. Okay, here we are with some of the latest near-field communication products that have come onto the market. Just to quickly go over them for you. NFC-equipped pen, NFC-equipped beer mat, laundry tags, new style key fobs, and a hanging tag. Very, very versatile. So, let's take a look at the NFC pen. Now this one really intrigued me because from a marketing point of view, the idea of being able to give away a little freebie to somebody, but at the same time have it technically cool and functional. What's better than having your brand written on the side of a pen, or your contact details written on the side of a pen, which people have to go like this to try and read the contact details, or something that's functional that instantly that pen can store data into a digital device. So, on this particular one, I've got the Androidizen website stored. So all you would need to do is scan it and off it goes. So let's just come back to a desktop. Scan. And you can see there it straight away loads the website up automatically. Nice and quick. If you actually want to store more data, the pen will store about 136 bytes of information, which is enough for a good sized address. A long website address, contact information like phone numbers and other items as well. To actually store information on to any NFC chip, I use NXP Writer. And if you actually go into the settings on this, you can turn it into advanced mode, well, pro mode, which gives you more writing options. So for instance, if I go into here and create a new item, I can actually do URIs, file URIs, as well as various other items as well, like SMS, etc. So you've got a few more different options for writing data. If you're using URLs, I tend to find URI works better in most cases. But to store the information, you simply select the tag you want to store, hit next, and then on the back of a Samsung device, look for where your logo is. That's the most likely area for your NFP chip. And then you wait for your chime, and it's done. And that's the information stored. Anyone who has an NFC equipped device can simply hold that underneath their NFC reader on their phone, or any NFC device for that matter, and read the data from it. But having that much information storable in a little pen like that, and bearing in mind most NFCs tend to be around 46 bytes of information, to be able to store over 100, really, really useful. Makes these quite versatile little units. Okay, here we are with the probably the coolest thing I've ever seen coming out of NFC technology wise. NFC in a beer mat. I'm pretty sure blokes everywhere right now are sitting there going, what a brilliant idea. If that isn't the killer app for NFC, what is? Basically, from a marketing point of view, you've got your traditional marketing and branding kind of stuff going on the printed surface, but embedded into here you have an NFC chip. So all I need to do to read the information is place my device on top of it and just move it. And then it will scan it. Now, I've stored no data in this yet, so let's have a look and store a quick bit of data. I use Tag Writer. I can create, and let's pop a web address onto this, and next. And all I do now, scan, store. Oops, store failed. There we go. And you can see on this one, there's 137 bytes that can be stored onto this particular tag. Then I can read that information back, simply pass the phone back over the tag, and it will fire the command. In this case, website address, but you can store anything on here. 137 bytes is going to be good enough to put your basic contact information in there, address, phone number, or a really long web address if that's what you want to do. Another way you can do it is if you store a short URL, so much shorter web address converted like bit.ly, then you can store a bit more information like getting your contact and full phone number and details in there as well. This really is going to open up a world of new ideas. The idea you could enter a competition just simply by scanning the NFC while you sat in the bar. You know, from a marketing point of view, people are going to really get this, especially as we now have more and more of these devices finding their way out into people's hands. You know, Galaxy S3, Galaxy Note 2, the new Nokias, any of the major smartphones coming through but the iPhone 5 or any of the Apple products, sadly. You know, we're rocking NFC now. It's only Apple that are holding things back, really. So, everyone, next time you're sat in the pub why don't you give your beer mat a quick scan and see if it's got NFC? And if it hasn't, complain to the landlord and say, I want NFC in my beer mats with my pint. Thank you so very, very much, sir. Okay, here we are with one of the smallest NFC chips I've come across so far in the commercial world. This is an NFC laundry tag. But I've spoken to the guys that have put this together, and whilst they say it's a laundry tag, it can be sewn into clothing. Their kind of view is that this can be used in much wider ways because it's a very small tag. So anywhere where you need a discrete NFC tag, this is absolutely ideal. So, for instance, you could pop this into packaging, into the bottom of packaging or boxes, and so you can scan the box from the outside. You could embed this directly within, a layer, for instance, within your product packaging. Or you could use smaller tags as well. You can drop these tags into different places or stick a bit of blue tack on the back of it and just use it as a temporary tag at an event or something. Just pin it up as and when you need it. Lots of versatility. For instance, this particular tag, I'm going to be just keeping in my wallet. Just in one little compartment of my wallet. Then if I need to quickly access one particular feature on my phone, flip open my wallet, scan the tag and off we go. Really, really small little versatile tag. They don't hold a huge amount of information though. So you're going to have to be careful about what you encode. I think this is really going to work nicely for URIs. So where you're not wanting to store actual information, what you're looking to do is store a universal resource indicator of where a load of information is, or to trigger a particular action set on your phone, which only requires a very small amount of data. Okay, so let's just have a look and see how much data we can store onto one of these. 46 bytes of data, which is comparable to your smaller key fob items. Like I say, perfect for storing something like a universal resource indicator on there, small amount of contact information like a phone number, but don't expect trying to put like whole contact details or anything like that on these. They are perfect though as little URI, or as triggers basically for actions on your phone, so turning your Wi-Fi on and off, plenty of data there to store those commands. One of the things that I really like about these small tags is how versatile they are. You can drop these into different places, throw a little bit of blue tack on the back of it, pop it in a pocket or something, and you quickly have access to the NFC's commands or resources as you need it. Bit more versatile because they're a little bit smaller than the other tags, so more options to use them. If you want to be discreet with your NFCs, if you just want to drop them in different places like I do, I have a habit of sticking NFC chips in very strange places in people's shops so I can quickly access their Wi-Fi and things like that with a new device. Hey, they don't know. But something like that, even more discreet. Okay, so here we are with an oldie but a goodie as far as NFC is concerned. These types have been around for a while. So near field communication built into a key fob, but these new style ones are really nice looking. My feeling with the other ones was that they felt a little bit plasticky, but not the good kind of plastic, not that kind of hard plastic that feels like it's worth a little bit of money comparably. You know, these are really, really nice. You're storing about 46 bytes of information onto them, so you're not going to be storing a huge amount of information, but enough for you to be able to do website addresses or, tasker commands and things like that for triggering actions on your phone. Setting up your Wi-Fi details, for instance, quickly enabling your phone to go into low power mode. Very, very nice and simple. You can keep the NFC on you, but these also make a very, very good corporate gift as well. So, you know, for those opportunities where you want to stand out from the crowd a little bit, something like this, especially as we're seeing more and more devices coming through with NFC now, great little opportunity for making a bit of an impression on people. This isn't just a key fob. This is a key fob with all our details loaded directly onto data. Okay, this is the NFC hanging tag. These are fairly new. They come out last couple of months or so. You can store 137 bytes of information onto one of these, making them one of the larger standard NFCs coming onto the market. Enough information there, you can store full contact details, so full address, phone number and things like that, as well as much longer URIs or more specific sets of data that you're trying to hold on there. Now, the great thing with these is on a little piece of elastic. So you can attach these to things and just have them stay nice and secure. You've got a slip knot on there as well. When the actual tag turns up, you'll find the slip knot is actually underneath the little buckle here, which actually makes it slightly shorter than you'd like. So I took my little cable off and just moved it around a little bit to actually make a longer hanger so that I can do that and attach it to things more easily. Always a possibility that you'll pop the loop, but it's good enough. Being able to store that much data makes these nice and versatile for using for Wi-Fi login details, for instance. much longer URI address details, and things like that. Basically, these are versatile, because you can just hang them places, they're great around the home. So I've got a couple of these now hung up just outside my front door. So one just outside the front door, one on the inside of the front door. And as I walk in, I can swipe to turn my Wi-Fi on, or swipe to turn my Wi-Fi off, depending on whether I'm coming or going. Great little tags, really coolly made as well. Not sure you can quite see this, but they're slightly shiny. And they have a really nice smooth edge on them. They look and feel premium. And you know, for NFC tags, I think we want them to feel good, don't we? They look good, they feel good if people have to touch them. And you know, they need to be durable, and that feels durable. There's very, very little flex, if any flex there at all, actually. So it's going to be hard wearing. Really like these hanging tags. So these are some of the latest NFC products coming onto the market. All I can really say is the future's bright, the future's NFC. Any phone that doesn't have NFC now is looking positively out of date. Hear that, iPhone? You're out of date, mate.